I am going to show you that is a very useful and a very good example I am going to show you here. What is the objective? This is my image and this is my objective of image. Counting number of objects from the images, measure the area of every object, as well as find the centroid of every image, every objects which are available in this image, and what is the bounding box. Bounding box means width and height of every objects. Okay, so this example I am going to show you. I am going to switch again in MATLAB. Okay, so this is the process which we are going to follow in this image. So first of all, what we will do, we'll do some kind of pre-processing. Then we will invert the image. Why image inversion? Because background is white, we have to do background as a blacks, that's why we are going to do a image inversion. Then further, it is not possible to detect mathematical calculations on color image, so we are converting that image as a binary black and white image. Then further, if there are some unwanted objects, we are going to apply some morphology to remove that unwanted objects from the image. Then we are going to detect the number of counts, means number of objects. Then we are going to label the objects, means similar kind of images in the same figure. Then we are going to do a measurement of area, and further we are identifying that which is the biggest object available in that image. Okay, so first of all, I am going to read that image. So read image, im read command is there. This is my image. Okay, the next step is conversion of image. So we are not going to do any pre-processing because our image is fine. Okay, so we are not going to use morphology in this case. So what I am going to do now, I am converting image as a gray format. Then I am using im complement. What it will do, let's say that any pixel intensity value is 25. If I use the im complement, it will minus from 255. Okay, so output will be 255 minus 25. So in this image, wherever there is white, it will become black, and wherever there is black, it will become white. So if I run this image, it will look like this. Fine. So there are lots of objects are available. Now our background is also black. So next step is to convert this image as a binary. Okay, after that, we are using one inbuilt function in MATLAB, that is beware open. What it does, if there are any unwanted objects whose pixel intensity count is below 100, that will be removed. Again, I am repeating, any object whose pixel intensity, count of pixels are below 100, count of pixels are below 100, that will be removed from that. Okay, let me run this command first of all. So you see here, this is a binary image. You can see these dots are unwanted objects. We don't want to count these objects, that's why we use this function beware open. Now you see the perfect objects we have, all unwanted objects are removed from here. Fine. Just 1 minute. Fine. Next, we are going to identify the objects in the image. So what I am going to do here, I am going to use one inbuilt function in MATLAB, that is bwconcom. What it will do, it will count number of objects. It will be saved as a CC. This is as a structure. If I have to extract the number of object, then CC dot number of objects. Okay. So here I provided 26. What it says, it is showing the connecting pixels. If two objects are connected with 26 pixels, it will be counted as a 1. 26 or more than 26, the object will be counted as a 1. Okay. Now if I run this, so you can see what output we got as a CC, as a structure, that is the image size and total connectivity and number of object, it is showing you 52. So total number of in that image. So you see, we had not to do anything manually to count the objects, we use this function in MATLAB. It counted the total number of objects are available, 52, and we got that. Okay. Now what we are going to do, we are going to identify a object which is at index number 40. So what we are doing, we are creating a false matrix, means a zero matrix. Let's see if I run this, what will happen. I am going to run this only, and if I type here objects, you will get the 0,0 matrix. Okay, and further what we are going to do next, at cc.pixel at index number 40, wherever this condition will be satisfied, the value will be 1. So we will get the object which is at index number 40, like this. Okay, fine. Okay, someone is asking that can we have codes on that which I am showing you. Yes, I will share later, don't worry about that. Okay, now next what we are going to do here, we are going to label that images. Why label is important? Let's say that in my single figure there are fruits, different kind of fruits. Let's say 10 fruits are there. Let's say 10 apples are there, 15 bananas are there. So what it will do, what it will label 10 apples with the same color and 15 bananas with a different same color. So that is a labeling. So in this case, the object which we created here as a CC, we are creating a label matrix for that. Then we use this command, label to RGB. It will label my all objects which are available here. So you see here, this color which you see, pink color, that are similar kind of images. So it's showing in this color, the yellow which you see, that is a similar kind of image. This is a way how you can label your images based on the color. So for this, what you have to do, you have to use label matrix or label to RGB in this case. Okay. Next, we have to find out the area, centroid and all these things. So what we are, there is a again inbuilt function in MATLAB. Instead of this, you can use blob analysis also. We don't have time, otherwise I will show you a blob analysis also to find out the area, width and height, all this kind of things. So here I am using region props, and this is my that is a structure which I detected from there. Okay, here I provided property as a basic. If I do a basic, it will detect the area, bounding box. Okay, if you have volumetric images, here you have to provide the volume. So what it will do, it will detect the area, volume of your images. Okay, so if when I run this, this output I will get the area of all objects, we will get the centroid of all objects, we will get the bounding box also of all images, objects which are available in that. Okay, like this. Okay, next we are what we are doing, I am creating one array with all the area. So my all area will be saved as a objects underscore areas. Okay, now what we are going to do, we are finding the area which is at position index number 25, that what is the area of that object. Okay, just wait a minute. So if I run this one, so you can see the area of object which is at index number 25, it is showing you 3807 units. Okay, now we are going to identify the objects which has a maximum area. Okay, so for to find out the maximum value, we use max command. Here is the area array, and what output I will get, this will be a max here. Okay, so max area I will get, and index I will get, that where is that object, what is the index of that object. Okay, fine. So I am going to run this. So you see here, this is the object which has a maximum area if I compare with other objects. So very simple it is. So how we are doing it here? First, again we created a false matrix, and wherever this condition will be satisfied, their value will be 1. And further, by using this command insert shape, you can insert a shape on that object. So I am inserting shape on original image as a rectangle, and this is the object data which I have as a ID. And the bounding box will be color, will be black, and line width will be 20. So if I run this, I will get this object. So this is the object which is detected, which has a maximum area in this case. Now we are going to plot the histogram of all objects which we have. So we use the histogram. If I run this, let's see what output is coming if I run this. So what it is showing you, on x-axis it is showing the area, and on y-axis it is showing the number of objects. Based on this area, how many number of objects are available? So you can see that there are 17 objects which lie between 6000 to 9000 units. Okay, this is showing the number of objects within that region of area. Fine. Okay, meanwhile, if you have any question, you can write in a QA. One quick example I will show you, that counting of circles. Then we will end this session, then we will start the question answers for that. Okay. The same process we are going to apply for this. Okay. So I am going to read this image which I have to identify the number of circles in this case. You can see here there are lots of circles. Manually if you count it, it will take long time, right? And also I want to find out the perimeter area as well in this case. So same process we are applying it. We are converting that image as a gray, then we are taking the complement of it. You can see the background became black. Then further we are using IM binarize to convert as a binary, and here you see I provided the value 0.20. It means the lower pixel intensity value below 0.20 will become black and above will become white. And then again we are removing any unwanted objects using the beware open command. So you see now we have a perfect without any noise. Okay. There is no any unwanted objects available here. Fine. Now again we are applying bconcom to identify how many number of circles are there. So in this case total number of circles are 85. Fine. Then we are identifying at pixel number 50 what is the circle and there. So here is the, this is the circle which is at index number 50. Okay, and again based on the area you can label that circles. So this pink color which you see, that they are that circles which have almost same area, and yellow color which you see, that are circles which have the similar kind of area. So like this you can label your images based on the pixel color, and to identify the area we use this command. And we will get the area. So you can see that in this case all circles were of same size. So areas of all object circles are also almost same, you can say it, right? And this is the centroid and this is the bounding box for it. Okay, that's all. So again the maximum area which we have by using max command here, we are using the max command to find out the index of the area which has a maximum value. Okay, and this is the circle which has a maximum